Welcome student to Praveen Patil College of Diploma Engineering and Technology. Myself Mrs. Smita Shekhar Kamble, our department Humanity and Science, course Basic Mathematics, course code 22103. So today's lecture obviously depend on coordinate geometry unit 3 chapter number 6. Our coordinate geometry is very interesting about the axis, intersecting line, parallel lines, slope of tangent, equation of the line having two points intersecting form. What is that? We have to revise some topic. Two non-vertical lines with slopes m1 and m2 are parallel if lines have the same slope m1 is equal to m2. Perpendicular if the slopes are negative reciprocal, that is m2 is equal to minus 1 upon m1, or equivalently if m1 into m2 is equal to minus 1. That means two lines are parallel, then their slopes are equal, and two lines are perpendicular, then their product of the slopes is given by minus 1. What you see in this diagram? This is the symbol, addition, or any interesting topic we have to discuss. From this purpose, we need the geometrical, that is a1x, b1y plus c1 is equal to 0, any straight line, a2x plus b2y plus c2. These two lines are intersecting with each other, that is x, y. We have to define the equation of line to form y minus y1 upon y1 minus y2 is equal to x minus x1 upon x1 minus x2. For be careful, intersecting point of any two lines will be same, that is 1. So that's why we have to take y minus y1 upon y1 minus y2 is equal to x minus x1 upon x1 minus x2. Find the equation of line passing through the point 2, 5 and intersecting of lines x plus y is equal to 0 and 2x minus y equal to 9. If we consider L1 is equal to x plus y is equal to 0, L2 is equal to 2x minus y is equal to 9, solve the equation simultaneously. Now, by mathematical way, if two equations we have to solve, first we have to take addition of that. Suppose 2x plus y, 2y is equal to 0. Why I take the 2? Because the coefficient you have to consider at is the 2. So we have to put the y is equal to 3 in equation x plus y is equal to x minus 3. Why I take this way? So we have to take the intersecting point, that is 3, -3. How we resolve this? Suppose I take x plus y is equal to 0, 2x minus y is equal to 9. So here we have to get the which formation? It is the obviously y minus y gives cancellation. 3x is equal to 9. I put x is equal to 3. So x is equal to 3 in this expression, I give that value of it is the y is equal to 3. So p is equal to 3 minus 3 and q is equal to 2, 5 is given. That means we derive the intersecting point and we have the given point 2, 5. Therefore, 2x equation of the line have the 2-point form is given by y minus y1 upon y1 minus y2. X up minus x1 upon x1 minus x2. So we have to put the value of x1 3, y1 minus 3, x2 2, y2 is equal to 5. So we have y minus 3, minus 3 minus 5 is equal to x minus 3 upon 3 minus 2. So simplification we derive y plus 3 upon minus 8 is equal to x minus 3 upon 1. We have to take the cross multiplication. Y plus 3 is equal to minus 8x plus 24. Simplification, I convert these 8x and 24 to these sides. How I derive? 8x remain as the same, their y remain as the same, 24 goes to this side, minus 24 plus 3 gives value minus 21, 21 goes this side, we derive the 8x plus y is equal to 21 is required equation of line. In this example, we have the in equation given 2, 5, the line passing through 2, 5, and they give the condition about intersecting line x plus y equal to 0, 2x minus y equal to 9. I solve these two equations simultaneously, we derive the value of suppose y is equal to 3. We put y is equal to 3 in the above equation, we derive p is equal to 3, -3 and q is equal to 2, 5. We have to consider the formula y minus y1 is equal to y1 minus y2 is equal to x minus x1 upon x1 minus x2. So we have to put in the values of x1, y1, x2, y2 in this expression. We simplify and we derive the final answer in the form of 8x plus y equal to 21. In this diagram, perpendicular bisector theorem we have to implement. If a point is on perpendicular bisector of a segment, then it is equidistant from the end points of the segment. In this diagram, obviously three vertices are there, A, B, C. If we draw the perpendicular bisector which passes through point B on the segment AC, then we have to prove that these A, and suppose we have to consider it is M, AM and MC must be equidistant with the line segment. So we have to use this theorem, but we have no about the slope format. So let us take, find the equation of perpendicular bisector the of the joining points 4, 8 and minus 2, 6. If two points are given, then 4, 8 is equal to A x1, y1, capital A minus 2, 6, capital B in bracket x2, y2. We have the midpoint formula x1 plus x2 upon 2, y1 plus y2 upon 2. We have 4 minus 2 upon 2, 8 minus 6 upon 2. So we derive P is equal to 1, 7. Why we need the midpoint? Because perpendicular bisector intersect the AC. That's why we have to use the midpoint formula. Now slope of line AB is given by y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. So perpendicular lines are m1 into m2 is equal to minus 1. Therefore, if we have to derive the slope of AB is given by y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. So final answer y2 is what? Okay, 6 minus of 8. Next, minus 2 upon minus 4. By simplification, we derive the slope of this 2-point form is given by m is equal to 1 upon 3. So we know that m1 is equal to m2 is equal to minus 1. We convert the m2 is equal to minus 1 upon m1. That's why L is equal to minus 1 upon 1 upon 3. 3 goes in a numerator. We have minus 3 is equal to M. The line L passes through the point P 1, 7. Then having M dash is equal to minus 3. Because we have to have the intersecting point, that is the midpoint, 1, 7. And our slope we derive from the given perpendicular bisector. That's why m is dash is equal to minus 3. We have the equation y minus y1 is equal to m in bracket x minus x1. Instead of m, I take m dash. So we have y minus 7 is equal to minus 3 x minus 1. I multiply minus 3 in a bracket minus 3x plus 3. So I convert the 3x remain as the same. Y goes to convert a minus 3 is there. So minus minus plus 3. So we have derived 3x plus y is equal to 10 is required equation of the perpendicular bisector. I revise which topic we discuss in this example. First, find the equation of perpendicular bisector of the line joining the points 4, 8 is given. and minus 2, 6. I consider the A point is 4, 8. A second B point is minus 2, 6. I put the midpoint formula x1 plus x2 upon 2, y1 plus y2 upon 2. So we have to take 4 minus 2 upon 2, 8 plus 6 upon 2, 1, 7. Then we consider the slope of line segment AB. So that is y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. And we know that perpendicular m1 into m2 is equal to minus 1. y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1 is derived from these two points, that is 1 upon 3. That's why we know the slope of the another line is equal to minus 1 upon m1. We have to put minus 3 is equal to m dash. Instead of m1, we have to take m dash. And we use the equation of the line y minus y1 is equal to m dash x minus x1. Therefore, final equation 3x plus y is equal to 10. Is the required equation of the line. You saw in this diagram angle between two lines. In geometry, you study about the acute angle, obtuse angle, right angle triangle. So, for slope, we need the acute angle in the form of the inclination format. But what is exactly acute angle? Suppose this is the piece of the pizza. We have to consider the one piece that is gives the acute form of the pizza piece. So we have the formula angle between two lines of the acute angle theta between two lines are both slopes are m1 and m2 are given by tan theta is equal to m1 minus m2 upon 1 plus m1 into m2. If the lines are parallel, then m1 is equal to m2. And if two lines are perpendicular, then m1 into m2 is equal to minus 1. That's why we have the theta is equal to b minus alpha. Why it is we derive this formula? Yes, let us check. It is the y-axis, it is the x-axis. We have the y is equal to m2x plus c2 and we have y is equal to m1x plus c1. This is the slope point form of the equation of line, that is y is equal to mx plus c. So now m1 is equal to suppose tan alpha, m2 is equal to tan beta. So that's why we have to consider these angle is acute angle theta. This angle is the acute angle of this line with the x-axis. Beta is the also acute angle of these lines. So we have to perform tan theta is equal to m2 minus m1 upon m1 plus m1 into m2 from this diagram. But if we take the bar bracket, that is the modulus, then we have tan theta is equal to m1 minus m2 upon 1 plus m1 into m2. Example, if theta is the acute angle between the lines with slope m1 into m2, then we have the tan theta is equal to modulus m1 minus m2 upon 1 plus m1 into m2. Example given by, find the acute angle between the lines whose slope are root 3 and 1 upon root 3. We have the formula tan theta is equal to modulus m1 minus m2 upon 1 plus m1 into m2. We have to put the value of m1 is equal to root 3. We have to put the m2 value is 1 upon root 3. We have the value 1 plus m1 into m2 means root 3 upon 1 upon root 3. We have to take the cross multiplication. Root 3 into root 3 is 3. We use the formula of law of indices. Root A into root A is A. That's minus 1 remain as the same, root 3 remain as the same. Here root 3, root 3 get cancelled. 1 plus 1 is 2. 3 minus 1 is 2. So cancelling 2, we derive 1 upon root 3. From the tan theta is equal to 1 upon root 3. That means theta in a tan sign gives 30 degree for tan inverse of 1 upon root 3 is 30 degree. So from this format we must need the table of the angle for tan